Hi, my name is Lawrence. Welcome to Kisi Unlocked, where we explain the ins and outs of access control and show you how to get the most out of your Kisi system.
Today we will talk about backup access control power supplies, benefits of using them, and how to install them.
Backup access control power supplies typically contain a circuit board, a standby battery, and an enclosure to store hardware neatly. Their main function is to power access control hardware, such as the Kisi controller probe, and to maintain power in the event of an outage. In this video, I will be talking about the Altronics AL600 ULXB board as an example and highlight the functionality. Backup access control power supplies may come with additional features such as swappable output voltage, power regulation, and failure supervision systems. In the event of a power outage, backup power supplies are a vital component in maintaining continual functionality of your access control system. This ensures that the doors you want locked stay locked and that their credentials remain functional in emergency situations. Backup power supplies are also used to regulate power and safeguards against unexpected and unregulated power events like power surges. Backup access control power supplies offer useful benefits for your access control systems. First, they are easy to set up and connect with Kisi controllers. They blend in with the background and do not have to be continually configured once they are set up. Additionally, they provide peace of mind by enabling access control systems to still work in power outages and regulate against unsafe power levels. For this installation, you will need lead acid or gel batteries, Kisi controller, and a backup access control power supply, such as the Altronics AL600 ULXB. Instructions may vary for your backup access control power supply, so be sure to read the manual prior to installation. I will be guiding you through Altronics' installation instructions. Refer to the sub-assembly installation instruction for mounting the board. Set desired DC output by setting SW1 to the appropriate position on the power board. Connect unswitched AC power to the terminals marked L and N. Use 14 AWG for all power connections, 22 to 18 AWG for power limited circuits. Measure output voltage before connecting your devices. Connect output devices to terminals marked positive DC and negative DC. Connect your batteries to the terminals marked negative battery and positive battery. Ensure that the standby batteries are lead acid or gel type. Your backup power supply should now be all set up. You can check if the battery is fully charged by measuring the voltage at the battery terminals and board terminals. Thanks for watching. Make sure to check out the description below for more resources. If you have any questions, make sure to leave a comment. Remember to click subscribe to stay updated on the latest in access control and physical security.